That said, at the end of the day, like, the code for doing OAuth 2 is not that bad. The standards are way more mature. It's way easier than the original OAuth spec. And you're not obligated to use our libraries, right? It's standard. We're compliant. So any OAuth library that you're already using in your application should work fine. And you just, you know, just have to change which endpoints and understand the scopes. I mean, kind of at the end of the day, the advice is very brief, I think, and, you know, very generic, which is really just, you know, understand the use case that you're trying to build, right? Pick whatever the simplest approach is that fits that, because you can get very complicated, unnecessarily so. Ask for the least amount of permission that your app actually needs. That sometimes is hard to do, but that's general good advice, right? Never ask for more permission than absolutely required. And then really just plan for some of the process overhead. A lot of the sticking points we see these days is not so much on implementing OAuth itself, but just navigating the process to get your app approved by our trust and safety team. It's not always a difficult process, but there's, you know, it is something that if you're not expecting the timelines or the requirements that they're setting or some of the feedback, right? Like, yeah, it could catch you off guard. But I think if you kind of go into it, you know, just aware of the process, great documentation, sort of like what they expect, but just read through that ahead of time, just so that you're prepared to navigate that process. And a lot of times it goes great. Sometimes there's hiccups in the process, and you know, we help people work through those. But it's a challenge, right? I mean, I wish it were easier, but we're getting there. But yeah, we have a way to go.